Hello, that's Gail. I work at a startup called Lima on master-master file system replication. And in this kind of system, something we care deeply about is called causality. The idea is, given a piece of replicated data and two events modifying this piece of data originating from different nodes, how do you know if one of those events could have influenced the other events? Or in other words, did one of those events happen before the other event? But we are in a distributed system, and we don't want to use things like work lock time, so we use constructs like version vectors. And the idea is that we attribute a unique identifier to every node in the system and a counter. And when an event occurs, we just increase the value of the counter corresponding to that node. And we can compare version vectors with a partial order. And the idea is that if given two vectors, there is one vector for which for every node in the system, the counter is higher than the other vectors, then we say it descends the other vector. So here on the left, alpha descends beta. And if we can find no such vector, we say that the vectors are concurrent. And we can merge the causality information of version vectors by taking the maximum of counters for every node. And well, this is something very popular in distributed systems, and it works well in most cases. But there is one case where it breaks down, and that is in dynamic systems with a lot of churn. So take a system in which devices come into your system, modify a bit of data, and then leave forever. And the issue you have in this case is that you end up having a lot of unique identifiers in your vectors, and they tend to become very large, and it's hard to garbage collect them. So this is an issue called actor explosion. And interval trick locks is a mechanism designed to fight this. So the idea is, instead of attributing a unique identifier to every node in the system, we take the real valued interval from 0 to 1, and we attribute part of it, not necessarily contiguous, as you can see, to a device. And when we want to add a new device into the system, we start from an existing device, and we fork it. So we take part of its interval, and we give it to the new device. And well, on top of the interval, we overlay an integer valued curve, which works a bit like version vectors. So when an event occurs, we just increase within our share of the interval the height of the curve. And we can compare them just like version vectors. If there is a curve which is above the other one, we say that the event descends the other event. Otherwise, if the curves intersect, they are concurrent. And when a device leaves the system, first, we merge the information into the information of another device. So we just, like with version vectors, we take the maximum of both curves. And then we give back our share of the interval to the device. And the beauty of this system is that no device has to know about all the other devices in the system. A device just has to know about the part of the interval it owns. And if we are being clever when we increase a part of the curve when an event occurs, and I can't explain exactly how in 4 minutes, but we can ensure that the curve is of relatively low complexity. And we can encode the curve using a tree-shaped data structure and an efficient binary encoding. And we can end up with something like this, where the size of the construct depends more on the number of nodes active on a piece of data at a given time than on the overall number of nodes that have acted on this piece of data since inception. So this solves the problem of actor explosion. If you want to learn more about this, I encourage you to read this paper, which is from 2008. It's one of the best papers on causality I have ever read myself. And at the bottom, I put a link of an implementation I wrote of the interval trick locks in Lua. And if you don't like Lua, I have links in the README to implementations in 5 other languages and also a link to the PDF of the paper. That's all for me. Thank you.